What is something someone said that changed your way of thinking forever? I was 34, with few skills, 3 young children, and just finalizing a divorce when I was discussing what to do with my future. My friend suggested that I return to school, possibly to study my newfound passion for geology. My response was, "Yeah, but I'll be 40 by the time I graduate." Her life-changing response, "You'll be 40 anyway." Now I'm 42, and 3 semesters away from completing my 3rd and last degree. As a teenager, I started pouting after a coach yelled at me. He looked at me, said, "The time to worry is when I quit yelling at you, because that means I've decided you're not worth the effort." Never make fun of someone who speaks broken English. It means they speak not the language. Wow, I feel like CRP now. My crazy German hippie godfather once sat me down when I was an angsty self-destructing teen and said, "Look, Kate, I love you, and I will always, always be here to help you pick up the pieces, but Jesus fuck, does there need to be so many pieces? The master has failed more times than the beginner has even tried." Stephen McCraney. Saw it first on Reddit, and it's stuck with me. If you want to be good at something, you first must be willing to be bad at it. My guitar teacher said this to me after I expressed that I felt like giving up because I wasn't making the progress I thought I should be making. It made a lot of sense to me, and it helps motivate me whenever I attempt something new. It doesn't take talent to practice. Isn't it funny how day by day nothing changes, but when we look back everything is different? C.S. Lewis. Never make fun of someone for things they can't change. After my wife left me, I had an older coworker tell me something like this: "Nothing I can say to you is going to make things easier or help you get through this, but just know that I'm here to listen if you decide you would like to talk." I was so weighed down with friends and family who loved me giving me unsolicited advice when all I needed was someone who respected me enough to just listen. I always take this approach with people who are going through hard times. If you truly care about them, just listen. Eventually they will ask you for advice. You are far more worried about what you say and do than anyone else's. Motivation is fleeting. Discipline is not. The only time you look in your neighbor's bowl is to make sure that they have enough. You don't look in your neighbor's bowl to see if you have as much as them. Louis C.K. An amateur practices until he can play it correctly. A professional practices until he can't play it incorrectly. When I was 12, I was criticizing someone's project in shop class. A girl came up to me and told me very calmly, "You're always criticizing people. Why are you so mean?" It was a very simple thing to say, but it hit me hard while my personality was still developing. I think her neutral tone was important too. Something clicked, and I realized she was right. I was kind of an asshole. It changed the way I behaved forever. I guarantee she does not remember the exchange, or even me at all. Sometimes it doesn't have to be something poetically profound, just something true said with honesty at the right time in your life. If you don't have time to do it right, you must have time to do it over. Everyone is the main character of their life. Now I stop and think, whenever someone is being self-absorbed, it's just they're excited over something that happened in their life, because that's what's most important to them. If it takes less than 5 minutes, just do it now. My wife was the first person to tell me that holding on to anger is like drinking poison and expecting the other person to die. It gets attributed to a number of people who probably didn't say it, but it really hit home when she was the one who told me. When my dog passed, my grandma told me pain is inevitable, suffering is optional. At first I thought what a pessimistic view this was, but over time I began to recognize the mental fortitude and optimism it contained. Eating a shitload may feel good in the moment, but take a look at how goddamn fat you are. Everyone else was too nice and kept telling me I looked fine despite being 250 plus lbs at 15. I was in McDonald's with my dad when I was around 10 year old. I remember him asking me to take the tray to the bin at the end, and I said that's their jobs. Someone else will do it. My dad said someday you may have to do a job you don't particularly like, and that other people could make easier or more difficult for you. You'll wish they made it easier. He also said fat girls will always be more grateful, so you kinda got to take it and leave it with my pa. My old biology teacher told me don't judge a book by its cover, but be careful about the library it's in. Basically, a good judge of character is the people the other person hangs out with. Still get to know them, hence the don't judge a book by its cover bit, but at the same time watch out for the social habits they have. If they hang around shitty people and do shitty things, maybe they aren't the best fit for you. I was in San Francisco on a school trip and I went out of our hostel for a cigarette. I was going through some shit at the time and wasn't handling it well. A homeless man came up and asked for a cig, so I gave him one and he sat and smoked with me. He asked what was bothering me, so I told him I was having some trouble with my girlfriend, but I was okay, and he told me something I've never forgotten. Son, stop pretending you're okay. You're not okay. Sometimes in life shit happens, and you won't be okay, but that's okay. Really resonated with me. Helped me come to terms with a lot of things in the years since. Whatever crawls up his ass won't give me a bellyache. My granddad allows me to distance myself from other people's drama. I'm a software engineer and tend to do my best work when I'm around people that are better than me. This quote has always stuck with me, and I make a lot of decisions with it in mind. If you're the smartest person in the room, you're in the wrong room. Hanlon's razor. Never attribute to malice that which is adequately explained by stupidity. People aren't mean, they're dumb. Approach a situation from that angle and you're a lot less defensive, a lot more capable of understanding. It was a comment I saw on Reddit a couple of weeks ago. I don't remember it verbatim, but it was something along the lines of how parents raise good children, but should instead be raising good adults. The thought blew my mind and really got me thinking. Let kids be kids. Let them screw up occasionally and let them be sad every now and then. They're only preparing themselves for the real world and will be ready to face it when the time comes. Most parents do a great job raising good children, and when those kids grow up, they are clueless how to handle real world problems. Wish I had a link to the comment to credit the user that posted that comment. When I was telling a friend of mine that I have a hard time believing that people can like me since I don't like myself, she told me, "We don't see you the way you see yourself. I know that depression alters the way I see the world, and that I see myself not as I should, but hearing that from someone else that actually cares about me really made it real. It's my go-to quote now when I struggle. It made me realize that sometimes I just need to change my perspective. Sorry for rambling so much. I never know how to stop or put anything into words. Some doors are closed for a reason. Completely changed my life. I used to always be up into everyone's business, inviting them to share. Do you want to talk about it? Even pressuring when they didn't feel like it. After all, I believed, if you talk about it, you'll feel better. Truth is, people need to be able to control who they discuss their problems with and choose their own time for, if/when they discuss it with others, and the last thing they need is some asshole encouraging them to open up. Get off their backs. If they are not sharing their problems with you, assume there's a damn good reason and let it go. If they need you, they will find you. Another truth is, learned this from a psychologist, sometimes people just need to stop talking about their problems and move on with their life. Not everything has closure. You don't make peace with every tragedy. Happiness is not waiting for you, if only you can come to terms with your childhood or some tragedy. Some mental wounds are like physical wounds. If you keep picking at the scab, it will never heal. Time heals most things, but you have to let it. Do you feel victory when your words cause pain? I grew up in an abusive environment, and I left it, but it took years for me to leave the actions I'd learned behind as well. I wasn't a good person, because I had no example. Being a good person is all I want to be. When you are torn between two choices, always pick the one that will make the best story. Grandpa always said this, and once I started following it, life became a lot more interesting. I was worried about being a bad father. Then someone told me a bad father wouldn't worry about being a bad father. Blew all my doubts away in a microsecond. Get busy living, or get busy dying. That one got me sober. 7 years and counting. I remember seeing this guy going above and beyond all the time. Always going the extra mile. I asked him why, and he said something kind of cryptic, but it blew me away at the time. To do what ought to be done, but would not have been done unless I did it. I thought to be my duty. Apostrophe. Now that I'm a father, I'm saying this shit to myself every day. We judge ourselves by our intentions, but others by their actions. This put a lot of things into perspective for me. You don't need a $1 million idea, you need a $1 idea that a million people will buy. My dad once asked me what I thought he'd be more disappointed about, smoking or cheating on a test. I'd never smoked, but I was definitely guilty of glancing at the person's paper next to me. Smoking. I'd always heard the don't do drugs speech. My dad just shook his head. One of those things is bad for your body. The other is bad for your soul. Your soul is more important. I don't know why that got to me, but it did. I used to work in this mail factory when I was a teenager, and, like any teenager, would sometimes frantically struggle to accomplish the most menial of tasks. Enter the quiet, huge gold-chained dude from Trinidad. Look, mon, you have to make work easy. All you have to do Monday. Just make work easy. Really simple and profound advice that has helped me in every job I've ever had. Simplify your task, and you can do it better and faster. I was in my early 20s and driving across some barren portion of the US. The only radio station I could get was broadcasting religious programming. It was better than silence, but just barely. One preacher was begging for money to help homeless girls. When a caller asked him about the danger of working at a shelter with atheists, his answer changed my life. I will work with anyone doing God's work, no matter what their reason, as long as they are doing so. If they deviate, then I will no longer help, but until then we are on the same team. A decade later, when Hurricane Andrew leveled Homestead FL, 30 miles from where I lived, this atheist volunteered with a church group to get supplies where they were needed. They didn't judge who they helped, and neither did I.